In this video, we'll explore different ways of choosing commands and tools and setting attribute values in Maya. To look at tools, let's start off by creating a primitive object. You can choose Create Polygon Primitives Pipe to create a pipe, or you can click the pipe icon on the polygons shelf to create that primitive. Unlike Softimage's primitives, choosing this command doesn't make the primitive pop up at the scene's origin by default. Instead, you need to draw the primitive in the scene wherever you want it. However, if you turn off Interactive Creation in the Polygon Primitives menu, you can make it work the same way as in Softimage. Then you can click the Options box beside any of these commands to set the default options for primitives upon creation. The Polygon Pipe command we chose is actually a tool. Tools usually have the word tool in their name, so that makes it easier to identify them as such. As in Softimage, tools are activated and then you do something with that tool, such as with the extrude tool. In Maya, there is no super mode for tools as there is in Softimage, so tools are always considered sticky, meaning that they stay active until you select another tool. This icon in the toolbox always shows the last tool that was used, so you can click it or press the Y key to reactivate that tool. This isn't quite the same as middle-clicking the menu name to repeat the last command on any menu, as you do in Softimage, but it helps you come back to the same tool that you were using. As well, if you're using the same set of tools a lot, tearing off their menu makes them easily accessible. You can set up the options for any tool using the Tool Settings panel. Select a tool, and this panel's contents are automatically updated with its options. Most types of commands in Maya are considered actions, where you choose a command and the action is done right away. Or you need to select an object or its component first, and then choose a command to do something to it. For example, select an object and choose Edit Duplicate. Or select a polygon mesh object and choose Edit Mesh Vertex Extrude. To repeat the last action, press the G key. And as in Softimage, you can press Ctrl-Z to undo the last action of any type, and Ctrl-Y to redo it, but we'll just undo that again. Some tools and commands are assigned hotkeys in Maya, but you can change them or assign hotkeys to other tools and commands with the Hotkey Editor. You'll probably want to keep most of Maya's default hotkeys as they are, but you could, for example, swap the hotkeys of some of the snapping tools, X, C, and V, with the hotkeys of the transform tools, W, E, and R, to be in more familiar Softimage territory. To change or assign a hotkey, select an item from the categories list, such as modify, then the command you want to change, such as the move tool. If you want to first see which keys are already assigned and which are unmapped, click the list all button. Enter the new hotkey that you want to use, which will be V in our case. You can optionally assign the Controller Alt modifier key with it. Then click Assign. If something is already mapped to that key, a message appears to warn you, so you can choose to override that hotkey or cancel the operation. The new hotkey is assigned to your userhotkeys.mel file in the Maya Prefs folder. If you want to return to the default hotkeys, you can either delete or rename this file. One thing that Maya has that's different from Softimage is the Hotbox, which is a shortcut to all commands on Maya menus. Move the cursor where you want the Hotbox to appear, then hold down the spacebar. Click on a menu name and drag to a command to choose it, then release the spacebar to close the hotbox. As with the menu bar, you can tear off menus from the hotbox. You can also easily switch views by clicking the Maya button in the center, dialing around, and selecting a view. Once you get used to the Hotbox, it's a great alternative to going to the menu bar or shelf all the time. In fact, if you want to keep your workspace really streamlined, you can hide all UI elements and just use the Hotbox to get all your commands. A quicker way to hide all the interface elements is to press Ctrl plus Spacebar so that you can view your scene and work in full screen mode. In Softimage, you can Alt plus right-click on any object to get a contextual menu for it, such as for polygons, surfaces, or curves. In Maya, you can right-click on an object to show commands and options that are contextual to that object type. These are called marking menus, and you'll use them all the time to work quickly. Drag the connection line to switch to another mode for that object, such as face, which is what you know as polygon mode in Softimage. Just a note that you can toggle between object and the current component mode at any time by pressing the F8 key. When you're in a mode, you can press Shift plus right-click to get menus for that object or component, such as the most common tools for faces. When you choose a tool from this menu, you can also press Ctrl plus Shift plus right-click to get options for this tool. And you can press Ctrl plus right-click to convert your current selection to another component type. For example, if you have this face selected, you can press Ctrl plus right-click and choose Two Vertices to select the vertices that are related to that face. There are also marking menus for the Select and Transform tools that you can open by pressing Ctrl plus Shift plus right-click when any of these tools are active. Or if you hold down the hotkey for the tool, such as W for the Move tool, and then left-click, the same menu appears for this tool. This menu gives you essentially the same options as you can get for that tool in the Tool Settings panel. One more thing you can do with marking menus is to create your own custom ones using the Marking Menu Editor, which is covered in another video. When you choose commands in Maya, such as to create an object, you'll notice that a property page, or PPG, doesn't pop up for editing properties as it does in Softimage. To edit properties, or attributes as they're called in Maya, you use the Attribute Editor. You can open the Attribute Editor in different ways, one of the easiest being to press Ctrl plus A. You can also click on its button in the upper right corner. These other buttons toggle what's displayed in this panel on the right: the Modeling Toolkit, Tool Settings, and the Channel Box. Just to note that in the Preferences window, you can select UI elements and then decide which editors you want to be displayed here by default. If other editors are open, you can click on the side tabs to toggle among them. In Softimage, you can click the tabs to switch among the different property pages in a property editor. In the Attribute Editor, you can do the same thing to show all the nodes that make up the object. Or right-click the arrow at the end to select the node you want from the menu. In Softimage, you can lock property pages so that the contents aren't updated when you change the selection. In the Attribute Editor, its contents update when you change your selection by default. But if you turn off List Auto Load Selected Attributes, its contents stay the same regardless of the selection. Then when you want to update the contents, just choose Load Selected Attributes. You can also click the Copy Tab button at the bottom to create a floating attribute editor whose contents stay locked on the currently selected object. And then turn on Auto Load and have the docked attribute editor update with the current selection. As well, you can keep the current selection in the scene, but then choose another recently selected object from the Focus menu to show its attributes in the attribute editor. When you change the attribute values, that object is updated, but the selection doesn't change. To change attribute values, you can drag the slider, or enter values in the text box, or press Ctrl as you drag over the text box. In Softimage, you can change the same property values for multi-selected objects in one property page. You can't edit attribute values for multiple objects in the attribute editor. However, you can use the attribute spreadsheet to do this. For modifying and animating an object's keyable attribute values, the channel box is really the preferred tool, and is very similar to the keying or KPL panel in Softimage. The keyable attributes are from the transform and shape nodes by default, as well as any input or output nodes. You'll find that the channel box has a few different options that the attribute editor doesn't. One thing is that you can change the name of the object here. Another thing is that you can select a channel, then middle-click and drag anywhere in the viewport as a virtual slider. You can change the speed sensitivity when dragging to slow, medium, or fast using the icons at the top of the channel box. You can even change the dragging speed to be linear or hyperbolic, the latter being useful for dealing with very large increments since it speeds up at the beginning and end of the dragging motion. If you want to have the same values for multiple channels, drag across to select them, or press Shift or Control, then type in a value and press Enter. To keep the cursor focus on the text boxes in the channel box instead of the viewport, press the Enter key on the keypad. For Boolean attributes, you can enter 1 or 0 to toggle that option, which is faster than typing on or off, or true or false. In Softimage, you can use math operations directly in the text boxes as relative operations, including things like randomize and linear. In Maya, math operations for addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division are also relative to the current value, but the syntax is a bit different. For example, you can enter plus equals 4 to add 4 to the current translate y value, or asterisk equals 1.5 to multiply the current scale value by 1.5. You can also add the percent sign as a suffix. For example, entering plus equals 10% adds 10% of the current value to each selected value. There are many more details about using the channel box and attribute editor, but that's a look at some of the basics. In the next videos, we'll continue with viewing, selecting, and transforming objects in Maya.